Setting up the VSL Synchron libraries for Dolby Atmos is a simple process if you follow these steps. First, Dolby Atmos does not work in 44.1, so you need your sample rate to be 48 or higher. Next, we will change our output and input devices to the Dolby Atmos bridge. This is so Logic will communicate with the renderer. In the renderer, set your preferences to the following: Core Audio, Dolby Audio Bridge, your audio interface, headphone mode on if you don't have an Atmos speaker system at your home or studio, and make sure the sample rate matches what you selected in Logic. Then go down to the headphone menu on the left and select bin-aural. Heading over to the Synchron player, we need to set each microphone position to a different output. Each microphone position is going to be routed to a different object or object pair in the Atmos environment. It is how we recreate the impression of the room so the listener feels like they're right there. Now that the Synchron mics have separate outputs, in Vienna Ensemble Pro, we need to set the outputs to the different Logic inputs. Press the plus sign to add these aux channels, which will send the individual sounds or mic positions separately to Logic. Each one of these channels needs a separate output. Set them accordingly in order. It is recommended, by me, you name each aux channel after each mic position, just to keep track of everything. Back in Logic, using a multi-out instance of Vienna Ensemble Pro, open the mix page and click this plus to add aux channels in Logic. They will automatically correspond to the inputs from Vienna Ensemble Pro. As you may know, some of these mic positions are stereo, some of them mono. The aux channels in Logic do not have the option for mono outputs. So, we need to send them to buses and make those buses mono. Of course, I like to keep these channels named after the mic position so I can keep track of what's what. To make those buses mono, click these little circle things so it's a single circle instead of two. Rename those guys. Now, we add the Atmos music panner to the mono buses as a mono plugin. The next part is critical. The object number in the Atmos panner must match the output number on your bus, aux, or audio track. In this case, object 11, then output 11. Mono outputs are hidden at the very bottom of the list in Logic. Again, this must match, otherwise you'll get all kinds of funky routing and nothing will sound right. Repeat this process with the other mono mic positions, only with the subsequent object numbers and outputs, so 12 and then 13 and so on. On the stereo mic positions, like the main mic in the Synchron libraries, assign the outputs to stereo output pairs not yet used by the mono mics. In this case, 15 and 16. Insert the Atmos panner on these channels as well, and assign the correct object number that matches the channel's output number. So, objects 15 and 16. You're getting it now, right? Repeat this process with the other channels. Get some music going. Now is the time to start moving these objects around. Just like this. Of course, any one of these parameters in the Atmos panner can be automated. The height, the depth, width, whatever. I mean, it really is whatever you can imagine in terms of movement, it's pretty much possible. As a reminder, you will be monitoring this mix as a binaural mix, so headphones will be required. This local renderer is a great option for people without access to an Atmos studio right then, who maybe you need to do like a pre-mix, or you just want to create a cool immersive audio track for headphone listening only. Whatever it is you want to do, this is a great option. Okay, bouncing out a binaural mix in Dolby Atmos takes place on the renderer, not in Logic. To do that, create a new master file and engage the record button. Play back the track in Logic. When it's over, disengage the recording button in the renderer. Now go to Export Audio to Re-Renders, then select Bin, B-I-N for binaural, hit Export, and boom, you've got an Atmos mix with your VSL Synchron libraries.